Wrong way! Cheshire! Not so fast! Can't even control the elements! Pathetic. Even funny!
Cheshire was having a grand time steering the lily pad every which way.
Cheshire, slow down! I'm soaked! I told you to go slow! Who's there?
How could this be? Before Cereza stood her mother.
Mummy? Is it really you?
Yes, my dearest Cereza.
Come this way.
Cereza.
The shade vanished, with a blood-chilling scream that...
Mummy.
Cheshire's strike had shattered the illusion, but it had taken a fright. She collapsed to her knees, her mother's final scream. Cheshire glanced down at Ceresa, but the tears would not stop.
Come on! If I hadn't dealt with that shade, you'd be face down at the bottom of that...
Cheshire! How could you? How could...
Unable to take Cheshire's abuse any longer, Ceresa left.
I save you, and this is the...
Why am I not surprised? I wouldn't expect a deep... And just so we're clear, you say I'm weak, but you can't survive...
Look at you! You wouldn't last 5 minutes in this forest!
Then came the straw that broke the demon...
Don't forget who summoned you here! Why...
Cheshire's eyes narrowed. Cheshire broke the silence with a threatening growl.
Good. That's it. We're through. I can get through this forest fine by myself. I'm not scared.
An odd structure appeared out of the gloom, towering before Ceresa.
Ceresa, you can do this on your own. You don't need anyone's help. Yeah.
Cereza was on her own this time. How was she going to get out of this pickle? Cereza had certainly grown stronger since entering the forest. But even so, making her way alone was proving more difficult than if only Cheshire were here.
No, I'm better off without that beast. I can...
Cereza heard a familiar voice. It was Cheshire. Injured.
Not my problem.
Somehow, Cereza had made it through. Solo adventuring was turning out much more difficult than she had anticipated. The optimism she had right after splitting up with Cheshire was long gone. Speaking of Cheshire, Cereza couldn't help remembering him. A colossal iron structure stood before her eyes. It was a fort built by the fairies. Cereza once again spotted Cheshire. Incapacity.
What has he gotten himself into now?
But before she knew what she was doing, Cereza had said...
I'm just going to take a look. I can't let anything happen to my stuffed cat.
Thank you.
talking to?
The fairies had captured Cheshire. Within their ranks was one... He appeared to be talking to Cheshire, but it was too far...
What does that fairy want with Cheshire?
The fairies carried him into some kind of...
Cheshire!
Forgetting the peril of her situation, Sir...
No good. You!
The elusive white wolf had... It called out to her before running away.
Where are you going? You know another entrance? Listen, this fortress is cruel.
But the wolf just stared at her, showing no signs of moving.
Thanks. You know, don't tell Cheshire I said that.
And so, Sarasa and the white wolf infiltrated deep.
What have you gotten yourself into this time? Turn that way. Oh well, it works for me.
Thank you. Within, the fairies seem to be arguing about something loudly.
I don't understand what they're saying, but if I know these fairies, it must be something absolutely nefarious. Reminds me of climbing the clock tower with Jean. She acted so tough, but I knew she was scared. To make it out of here. Yes! Just keeps going. Cheshire, where are they taking you? Cheshire! Cheshire!
They had finally found Cheshire. He was covered in wounds, hiding in the shadows. Sarissa was surprised to hear one of the It is simple! Stay out of our way! They were speaking Enochian, the language of angels and demons. Sarissa felt her heart beating. What will it be? Sarissa waited for his answer. Then she heard the familiar deep.
Oh.
I can trust a fit. Despite his battered body, Cheshire's eyes still...
Cheshire!
Thankfully, the white wolf held them... The sudden appearance of two intruders had the... Cereza seized the opportunity and freaked... It was splendid teamwork.
To see you're up for a fight. These naughty fairies are...
Not bad. Better than your crying. Punishment. A large gash was cut on Cheshire's leg. Bits of cotton were falling out, along with his magical energy. The fairies had not been kind to their cap. Unless the wound was mended, the magic-infused threads that bound Cheshire to this world would not last long. Cereza needed to suture the wound as soon as possible. There was only one way she could think to do it.
Remember, Cereza. As blood flows through veins, magic flows through a witch's hair.
Sorry, Morgana, but I found something more important.
These were the precious locks Cereza was growing out to resemble her mother. As expected, they worked their magic. Cheshire's... Don't blame me if that teacher of yours has a fit. Cheshire said,
Besides, if it wasn't for me, you wouldn't be in this mess in the first place. I promised to send you back. Umbra... What I'm trying to say is...
But before she could finish, Cheshire had already returned to his miniature form. What?
Yes, your magic...
Ceresa gave Cheshire a tight embrace. Somehow, she felt that Cheshire...
Restoration magic! I've never been able to pull that off before. I wonder if it might work on something else. I'm so shabby now, huh?
No, a cut like this is nothing. But this ribbon isn't so bad.
Cheshire said in a slightly embarrassed voice.
Yeah, I think it suits you perfectly.
Something made them stop. A strange presence. It was the regal fairy from earlier.
Hey! That fairy's speaking our language!
Sorry! Her instruments knows no bounds, no limits, or a king's anger would stoop it.
The regal fairy continued his haughty monologue. Still his thick...
What? Okay. So it was you who did all that awful stuff to Cheshire. I see.
Human and demon dead challenge Spooka, whose name strikes me as a whole.
Let's go! rises. Oh, we meant to run! Business.
Oh!
If I use my magic to fix it. What's he saying now?
The two sensed danger in the fairy named Pooka's words and began to run.
Long live the fairy!
What? What the? Oh, give me a break!
Realizing what had happened, Sarasa hurriedly began wiping her face clean. The spectacle was too much for Cheshire. He rolled with laughter.
Oh, now it's personal. That creepy fairy best hope we never cross paths again. Okay, Chucklepuss, joke's over. All right, let's get a move on.
Sarasa frowned and stormed off. Trying unsuccessfully to control his laughter, Cheshire followed after. The sphere burned with a bright red light. The two had arrived at the final elemental core.
Number four. We destroyed all the elemental cores. You know what that means? Here's the last elemental power. Let's give it a try. Okay?
Cheshire gave an annoyed snort. He'll show that smug face of his before long, I'm sure.